These days, as we know, law is the upcoming field and there's a boom in the industry. Reason being, loads of subjects, loads of people opting for law and loads of options in law, the per se. But then there are certain things about law or fraternity that we don't learn or that we don't understand during our college days. So certain things, you know, the practical skill set, because law is all about the real work, the field work, and we fail to get that understanding, that skill set during our law days, or be it even in internship days, because we know that the you know, our seniors, be it advocate, they don't have the bandwidth to teach a fresher as they are busy focusing on their clientele. So when I joined Law Seekho, our model, the courses that we offer, basically more than the course, the things that we offer via our courses are, you know, impeccable. They are something that no one in the industry offers. Or even being from a law fraternity and a postgraduate, I feel that there's so much in law that I haven't learned over the years. So, you know, Abhide, when I talk to people about Law Seekho, or when I try and, you know, understand the issues our students are facing, they are very, you know, they have a very positive response towards the courses, because they think that there's something, you know, that they aren't learning in their college days, but we are offering them. But the issue comes wherein that they say, ma'am, we are pursuing law. It's a 5-year course. You know, our parents have put in such an effort. And then if we ask them about the money for the other courses that we want to, how do we convince them? You know, and I believe that they are right on that part, because if it would have been for me also, how should I go and, you know, tell the parents that no, this is different, and what your student, the child is actually doing in the law days or in the college, that's different. You know, how do we convince the parents that let them explore, or, you know, opt them for the extra courses that they do?
A lot of law students experience guilt while asking their parents for money to invest in a course. Some of them don't experience guilt about the money, but they think that, should I not be studying for my university exams, working on the projects, and instead also take up a course? Is that kind of aggressive investment and pursuit of additional courses justifiable? So one thing we must be very clear about is that our LLB degrees are not guaranteeing us jobs. Okay, and many LLB degrees cost lakhs. Any national law university also would have the fees of 1.5-2 lakhs a year easily. And law colleges charge anything, even private universities charge around 80,000 a year minimum. Okay, there might be some state universities which are cheaper. Now, irrespective of that, what you need to know is that your parents have anyway invested and will invest a lot of money in your education. Their sole intention is to ensure that you are capable of building your own independent life and career. Okay, and that includes getting a job and moving towards your success. So the question that you need to be looking at is that when you're already spending lakhs, okay, let's assume that you're spending, say, 8 lakhs over the course of 5 years on your LLB degree, then how much does a Law Seekho course which costs, say, 30,000, okay, how much of your full 8 lakhs is it? It is actually less than 5%. Now, if you pay 5% more, then what is the likelihood that of getting better career opportunities and jobs? If that increases substantially by anything more than 5%, then you want to go for it. Now, we promise 10x or more value in any of our courses. So if you spend 30,000, you should expect to get more than 3 lakhs worth of value. Okay. Now, if you end up drafting an independent contract and helping a friend also, you will be able to charge 30,000 easily. If you charge a lesser amount, you can charge, let's say, 10,000 and do 3 contracts in 30,000. So covering up the cost is going to be a non-issue. The fun starts after that, because if you manage to land a good internship or do better at an internship than you'd have otherwise done, then the kind of career opportunities you get access to are unparalleled. So I have spoken to students who say that they went to an internship where they were not given work, and they were just sitting through the month reading some books that were given by the associates. Now, the reason they were not given this kind of work was because they could not be trusted with the work. And now I told them to imagine that if you were an associate and if the firm was to consider hiring you, would it have hired you? Simple reason being that when it comes to the firm to pay you for your work, then they will not, because they can't trust you with the work. Now, if on the other hand, you were able to deliver what their associates were doing, then they'd be more than happy to hire you and pay you well. And you'd have a multiple range of options. Can you imagine the kind of opportunities that open up for you? What will that do for your confidence? What will that do for your earning capacity in future? So now many of the law students we speak to don't have a sense that this is actually possible. Sometimes they get that sense, but then they don't believe that this can actually happen in an online course because of past experiences they have had or because of a general mentality of resignation. Okay, but when they actually get in touch with our system, they experience it for a couple of months, they are completely blown away. And over the course of the year, when they pursue a course with us, they realize there are so many new opportunities which open up for them. And this is a regular feature now. So once you start looking at the fact that this is possible, all you need to do is share that this is your vision with your parents. And like you, your parents have also had their own share of, you know, being misled by false promises, advertising, marketing, making tall claims and not fulfilling them, right? And so they are also going to play conservative. Expect them to play conservative and tell you that, you know, focus on your studies first and then look at something else. But remember that your studies are only going to get you your LLB degree, and that's the license to practice. That license doesn't even give you a stipend. Okay. Lawyers talk sometimes that the bar council in the state should give you some kind of a living stipend, but that's not a reality in the country. What you have to do is earn your way through your own professional skills by serving clients. So if that is possible, that's the vision you need to share. And you need to be clear that that's what you are setting out to achieve. Many law students go to their parents and ask them for, and they share about an online course. Then they ask them for their opinion that what do you think? Should I enroll in this? Now, hello, if you don't tell your parents what you want to do, why this is important, why you think this is better. Like, I've had conversations for half an hour, 1 hour, and people are convinced that this is going to add value to them. But they don't have that confidence when they share it with their parents, although they fully believe in it. Now, why are your parents going to support your vision? They're not. Okay. Now, the fun part about this is that this applies not just to the LawSeco course you want to enroll into, but any ambitious decision you want to take up. You want to intern outside the city you are currently studying in or living with your parents in, same problem will arise. You want to pursue a job outside your city, same problem again will arise. So the question is that you need to share your vision clearly and stick to it and explain why it is so important for you. Okay, and remember that if you are focusing 100% on your academics, you'll still not get your job. By chance, if you focus 80% and you get 20% less, you are 5 ranks below. But you are outstanding because you spent 1 hour a day for a year learning practical skills. That's going to make you stand out. So make sure you have a very clear conversation with your parents and follow through. It's not that you will have one conversation and they will agree. And you also don't need to wait to meet them personally. In case they are in a different city, you don't have to wait for months till your summer break or puja break or some other vacation to go and meet them personally and talk to them. You can just call them up and have a conversation. And you need to frame the issue clearly and confidently that you are asking them for sponsoring you for a course. Okay, do not mince your words around it. Don't be tentative. Only then you can have a real chance at getting it. And it might take 2 or 3 conversations with your parents. But what they are looking for is your clarity and your confidence. They are not law experts. They don't know what's going to be the best for you today. Even if your parents are lawyers, they may still not know what's the best for you today. And you may know better. And all they want to see is that, do you know what you're doing? So make sure you explain that.
Yes, I believe like every point that you said is absolutely right, because at that age, students are so tender because they have just school graduates, and they don't understand if they invest today, the return of investment, any course that they are seeking with the practical skill set, what can lead to them, you know, the rate of investment. Because you are right, because they don't know themselves only what they actually want. When I started talking to people, I made them understand that this is what you are losing at and this is what you will gain. And then they get the confidence to talk to their parents. And then that gap, you know, as you said, that parents would only show the, you know, confidence in you when you have that confidence. So what more means, how do you think a student, you know, after, how should they, you know, pursue their career about it? Supposedly it's 5 years. Until second year, third year, they say that I haven't studied IPC, though I'm interested in criminal litigation. But then I think I will do this course 3 years or 4 years down the lane, because you say it's a practical skill set, but I haven't studied about that subject. How will you, you know, tell students or ask them that it's better You know, I don't have any knowledge about it. Then how
and
will
they've
I
not
see?
Studied it
They
in
have
college.
not studied it yet.
Okay.
So what benefit will that give me if I do it proactively today?
Okay. So I think the important part is that opportunities don't wait for you to be ready.
True.
And they don't come at your own convenience.
Absolutely.
Okay. So once you have started studying law for 5 years, that means that now maybe in your second year, you might have to work in a corporate law firm. Maybe at the end of your first year, you will go to the local courts and have experience with a litigator.
True.
Okay. So, and you might end up studying that subject 2-3 years down the line. Now, the question is, do you want to deprive yourself of the benefit of knowing that subject and using it right then and there? That's the question. And that's why you need to decide that, you know, what is okay for you? What do you want to know?
Absolutely.
And get into the field. The second point about this is that there is a very simple logic of compounded returns. Once you learn something, all new knowledge stands on top of that. And the strides you make forward after getting one step forward are increasing. So your returns increase over time. You do an additional course which increases your skill sets by 5x in your first year. By the end of your fifth year, you will be 50x ahead.
Yes.
But there are people who think that agar mujhe job fifth year ke baad chahiye, to I will enroll in the course in fifth year.
Absolutely.
Okay. So now what will happen? They will get that 5x leap. They will not be able to compound their returns over time.
True.
So that is what calculation you need to make when you are actually calculating the return on investment on a course and selecting the time that when should I enroll.
Great. I mean, thank you so much, you know, because certain things, because in order to talk to them, you need to understand certain things by your own self also. So thank you for, you know, giving me such good things that there is so much to it. And yet we fail to understand that there's beyond law, there's beyond BLLB and those sections, you know, bare acts, that we can learn so much about it. Thank you.
You're most welcome. And if anybody has any questions, they can write to us. They can comment below the
Absolutely.
Video and we'll be happy to take them.